I'd like to direct your attention. We're going to start today in your program on page 8. And there will be portions that you will be joining in with our choirs, and they will be in bold. This time, please make sure all electronic devices are turned off. And let's praise our Lord.
Thank you. for my Lord, who will be a witness for my Lord, who will be a witness for my Lord.
Christ, Thank you.
Wow, that was great. Speechless. I guess the first thing I'd like to do is to introduce to you the choirs and their directors. Let's thank them personally for coming down to Nebraska and sharing with us the gifts the Lord has given them. The first choir I'd like to recognize is a choir from Great Plains Lutheran High School. That's the Honor Choir. Would you guys please stand up? Our next choir from Huron Valley Lutheran High School, the Hawk Singers, and their director, Kirsten Caston. From Illinois Lutheran High School, Micah Tan, and their director, Josiah Willits. From Luther High School, the Sound Foundation and their director, Mr. Paul Adix. From Michigan Lutheran High School, the Festival Singers and their director, Ryan Stockwell. Minnesota Valley Lutheran High School, the Charger Leaders, and their director, Mr. John Herbinson. From Rocky Mountain Lutheran High School, the Eagle Choir, and their director, Don Punky. St. Croix Lutheran High School, the Choraliers, and their director, Casey Pufall. From West Lutheran High School, the Western Accents, and their director, Gregory Bars. Finally, the host choir from Nebraska Lutheran High School, the Knights of the Round Table, and their director, Mr. Stephen Springborn. If you'd like a CD of this performance tonight, they are for sale. You can fill out a form out in the entryway there. Also, I have a few other thank yous I'd like to share. First of all, I'd like to thank the faculty and staff at Nebraska Lutheran High School. They've put in weeks, months of work to get ready for this. Let's thank all the faculty and staff here. I'd like to thank the parents of our Knights of the Round Table, and in particular the family of Mr. Scott Richard for putting together our barn dance. It was wild last night. Thank you. I'd also like to thank the nine congregations and the host families in their nine congregations for putting up all of these kits. Thank you so much. Mr. Stephen Springborn is going to come up. Thank you.
right. The first thing I think I need to do is to recognize our clinicians. Can I have you both stand up? Jody, can you stand up first, please? This is Jody Rowe. She comes from Atlanta, Georgia. And she was actually my choir director when I was at MLC and taught me voice lessons and everything that I needed to know about directing adolescent singers. And so I was so excited to ask her to join us today. So can we thank her, please, for all of her. Branches band, and so I've seen them perform a few times, and we've had conversations about his doctoral work in composition and in conducting as well, and so I wanted to give him the students a chance to work with a composer. So he wrote two of the pieces that were performed tonight, and he also was the one who arranged the saxophone part for the last piece. So we can welcome Mr. Jeremy Barker as well. Two big thank yous I have to make. First, thank you, Mark Adi. There was so much I didn't have to think about because Mark handled all of the volunteer coordinating and all of the things that everything you didn't see here, really. Mark handled almost all of that for me. So thank you so much, Mark. And also I need to thank Dave Ring, who was helping out with all the technology coordination, because all the light moving and the sound and all of that, he helped out with all the long nights and early mornings getting all this set up. So thank you two very much. Another special thank you to Luther High, specifically Paul Adix and James Monkey for bringing all of the sound stuff, because we don't actually own any. So thank you so much for generously helping us out with that this weekend. Thank you. I have to make sure to thank Kirsten Kasten for being the other accompanist tonight. Thank you so much. Joshua Severide is my student teacher right now, and he not only played the saxophone for us tonight, but he also wrote the Be Thou My Vision that we played during the offering tonight, so thank you very much. And this is a great in the program because it kind of just got set in the last couple of days, but thank you, Paul Adix, for being our percussionist for the day.
Putting together a festival like this is an enormous job. There are many, many hours of work, thinking ahead, anticipating problems, putting together, coordinating, scheduling, helping with transportation, taking people like James and myself home at midnight and making sure that happens and we don't have to sleep here. A lot of details, and this would not have happened without the tireless work and dedication of Mr. Springborn. Let's recognize his hard work. Thank you, Mr. Springborn. In a little town called Onalaska, a couple of directors got together and said, let's have a little festival. Let's see where this goes. And a couple of schools got together and they had a little concert where the students sang for each other, and that was kind of fun. And then they had a Sunday concert dedicated to God's glory. And here we are 49 years later, standing in Nebraska, enjoying the incredible benefits of Christian education. Our students have gotten together and had a wonderful weekend of fellowship, musical growth, and most importantly, acknowledging their Lord and Savior in song. What a wonderful blessing, and it's my unimaginable privilege to invite you all to Luther High, more specifically to the La Crosse Center, November 10th and 11th and 12th of 2017, where we will have the honor of hosting the 50th anniversary Choral Festival. It's going to be in the main arena. We'll have seating for about 4,000, so we'll have plenty of room. We would invite you all to come to the Friday night Pops concert and the Sunday afternoon sacred concert, and we hope to see all of you there. Our students are brought together by a love of music, but they're united by their faith in Christ. I think it's fitting and proper that one last time we ask our students to stand and put our hands together and give glory to God, our Heavenly Father, who has given us this incredible message of the gospel, the incredible gift of music, and these wonderful young people you see before you. Students, please stand. Let's recognize them.